Hi all, Karthik here from Design School by WP Algorithm. In this video, I want to show you how you can add dynamic content conditions to your website. Well, what exactly is dynamic content? Before I show you what we're going to do in this video, let me tell you, in Elementor, there are a lot of ways to achieve dynamic nature to your website. So if you have any widget, most of the fields will have something called dynamic. If you have Elementor Pro, only then this is accessible. And when you click on it, you can link each of the fields to the available dynamic options. You can also link them to ACF field. So title can be linked to an ACF field that corresponds to a text, and link can also be linked to an ACF link field, and so on, right? So that's one way to achieve dynamic nature in your website using Elementor. Of course, this dynamic feature needs you to have Elementor Pro. And one more way to achieve dynamic nature in your website is when you publish any theme builder templates such as header, footer, single page, archive page, 404 page, and so on. When you click on the right arrow, there's something called display conditions. And when you click on it, you can either choose to show this particular template on the entire website, or you can exclude them from certain pages or certain archive pages. And you can pick any of archives, and there are a lot of conditions for this. Well, what if you can hide individual elements such as this button using the same logic? What if you can hide it for certain users and show it for certain users? And this will help us achieve more dynamic websites. Let me give you a simple example. In my header, what if I can show this login button to those who didn't log in? And what if I can show the profile picture to those who are logged in, right? It's a simple thing, and that requires us to have PHP code, but without any code, I'll show you how you can do it with a plugin called Dynamic Visibility. So in WordPress repository, search for Dynamic Visibility. It's the same plugin by dynamic.ooo. They make really cool plugins for it. So it's this one. You need to install and activate it. I just activated Dynamic Visibility for Elementor. I just reloaded my header template, and this plugin will work with the free version of Elementor. Unlike the dynamic options, which are only available to the pro users, this plugin will work with even the free version of Elementor. So coming back to our logic, we'll show this button to those who are not logged in. So we'll prompt users, or we'll ask users to log in subtly by using this particular login button. And to those who are logged in, we'll hide this and we'll show this. Also, for those who didn't log in, we'll hide this and show this, right? So the logic here involves hiding and showing this on and hiding and showing this alternatively, right? So if the user is not logged in, you'll show this button. If the user is logged in, you'll just show him a profile picture, which you can link to maybe a menu or a pop-up. So you can show him his subscription, his account, his dashboard, whatever. And this would redirect users to log in if they didn't log in, because we are showing it to those who didn't log in. So how do you do that? Once you install and activate the dynamic visibility by dynamic.ooo, just click on any widget. So I have a simple header here, a logo, menu, a button, and then I have an image, and the image is linked to user profile picture, and this requires Elementor Pro, and the plugin itself doesn't require Elementor Pro, but I'm explaining the logic that I'm talking about, showing this to those who didn't log in, and this is actually the profile picture of the users that logged in, right? So I'll just click on this widget. It'll work for widgets and even sections, but not columns. So when you click on a column, the visibility tab is gone. But when you click on section, you can see that there's a new tab called visibility. I'll click on this button, go to visibility. You can enable or disable visibility. I just enabled visibility. You can hide this block until you re-enable it. We just need this block, but we need it in certain conditions. You can also choose to keep or remove HTML. So basically, when you choose not to put this HTML, it'll remove the whole code. So even in HTML, this element won't be present. But if you choose to keep HTML, it will be just hidden by using visibility property. It's a CSS property. You can simply remove this, just a little bit of optimization there. And here you have something called display mode. Here you can choose to show or hide the element, right? First thing, you need to enable visibility, and then you should select what you want to do with this element. I want to show it. I want to show this particular element, right? And I want to show it to those who are not logged in, so that they can click on this, they'll be taken to a login page where they can log in. So under this, you have something called user and roles. I can click on roles and it will show me all the available roles. Obviously, the visitor who is not logged in will have this profile. So I'll just click on this and that's it. I'll update it. We'll see that preview in a bit. Again, we'll come back to this. This is a dynamic profile picture. So I'll go to visibility again. Visibility is again enabled on this. And I want to hide this element. So here we're showing it for those who are not logged in. And here I want to hide it for those who are not logged in. Simple as that. And the converse is also true. So when you show it for those who are not logged in, it'll also be hidden for those who are logged in. And the converse applies to this. Since we are hiding it for those who are not logged in, it will be shown to those who are logged in, right? No confusion. So whatever condition you pick here, show or hide, and the opposite will also be applied to that particular element. When you choose to explicitly hide this element on a particular condition, when that particular condition is not met, the element is shown. And when this particular condition is met, it will be hidden. The same applies to this. You're trying to show the element on a particular condition, so it will show that element when that particular condition is met, and if it's not met, it will be hidden. That's a simple logic. Anyway, since I'm logged into my website, I can simply click on the eye icon and preview, and once my preview loads, you can see that I don't see the login button here. That's because I'm already logged in, as you can see here, and that's how I access dashboard in WordPress, right? So since I'm logged in, I do not see the login button here. What if you open a new browser or maybe a user who didn't log into your website? So I'll open up from another browser, and once my website loads, all I see is the login button, but I do not see the profile picture here. That's because in this browser I didn't log in, and the logic says show the login button to those who didn't log in, and the logic also says hide the profile picture from those who didn't log in. On the other hand, in this browser I logged in, so the login button is hidden and my profile picture is shown. And you can link this profile picture to a central dashboard and all that fancy stuff. But this is one of the many ways in which you can use this dynamic visibility feature. And there's one more thing to note here. If you select show or hide, and if you select any of the conditions, so there are different types of conditions, user and role, device and browser, date and time, conditional tags, you should only pick one from either of them. So you cannot have conditions work in conjunction with each other. So you cannot pick user and role, and you cannot add this condition to that, because they are all independent. You should either pick user and role, or you should pick device and browser. You should either pick date and time or this. All of them don't work together, and that's kind of a bummer. I think they'd add the ability to work together, but it's not there. So you can either pick user role, or you can go to device and browser. I'll basically hide both of them. So I'll change the visibility to hidden, and I'll hide it when the browser is Google Chrome. I'll also do the same thing with the profile picture here. I'll hide it when I'll remove the first condition. Since I told you can use only one of them, I'll go to device and browser, and I'll hide it from Google Chrome. Let our header preview reload, and let's see what happens now. Both the elements are hidden because I'm accessing this particular website from Google Chrome. So there are a lot of conditions for it. So you can also hide or show it for different devices. So for desktop and TV, for devices that have big wide screens, you can show this particular element or hide it based on the toggle that you pick here. You can also choose to show or hide it from a particular date and time. You can also pick days of the week. I'm not going to pick any of them. It's quite simple. And then there are something called conditional tags. You can read more about them. So each tag refers to a particular condition. It's a WordPress standard. They didn't make it up. This is a standard available. And if you understand this, as you can see here, is front page is when the front end of the site is displayed. It's a page or a post. It doesn't matter. Whatever you've set your front page, it can be home page. So let's pick that. So I'll pick the logic. I'll change the logic to hide both the elements. I'll remove rest of the logics so that this particular logic will work. I'll just make sure that everything else is clean. So and I can come to conditional tags. I can choose front page. So I'm actually choosing to hide this particular button on the front end or the front page. Sorry, I'll do the same thing with this particular image. I'll try to hide it on front page. You can also do the same on 404 page or anything, and you can pick multiple of them. You can also choose to show or hide it 404 page and front page. Either way, I'll just choose for front page. Now, according to our logic, both the button and the profile picture should only be visible on the front page, but not any other page. Let's click on wpalgorithm.com, which is my website, Sorry, it's WP Freedom. Now on my front page, I don't see the button and the profile picture. If I click on any other page, I'll see both of them because that's the logic we set. This logic or this conditional logic can also be applied to any content. It doesn't have to be header. It can be any element of widget or section. So you can apply it to all the free widgets. So if you have a text editor widget, you can show or hide it, or maybe you can show different text editor widgets for different languages. If you have a condition like that. So it all depends on how you implement this logic. And there's one more use case that I'll suggest. So if you have different discount for or pro users, so let's say you have two categories of users, business users and expert users, such as similar to what Elementor offers. And if you want to give a separate discount to both of them, you can create a section, one for the business users and one for the expert users. And based on the role logic, you can choose to show them to one of them, and the same logic applies to both of them. So you can show different discounts to different tiers of customers, and this examples go on and on. That's it for now. That's a quick overview of how to add dynamic content conditions to your Elementor website using dynamic visibility for Elementor. It's an excellent plugin. It has a lot of potential. Let me know how you guys would use this on your website. That's it for now. Talk to you in the next video. Peace.